Hi, I'm pro saxophonist Jamie Anderson, and you're watching Get Your Sax Together, brought to you today from a beach in Ibiza. I've just released Improvisation Mastery, and so I decided to chill out. Not really, I'm just messing around with the green screen. But on today's episode, you're going to learn why Michael Brecker is one of the greatest funk and blues players of all time. I'm going to rave about it, and you're going to find out why he has got Improvisation Mastery. Hope you enjoy it. Yeah, the truth of the matter is the Get Your Sax Together studio is in a state of complete disarray because I've been working from 6 a.m. on Wednesday morning right through to the end of Friday night, continuously without a break through the night to get Improvisation Mastery out, which is done. So you can get hold of Improvisation Mastery, but the special launch offer is only open for a few days. You've got until Tuesday at midnight. So most of you watching this video in the future will be thinking, what am I talking about? But you'll still be able to buy the course, you just won't get the special deal. So jump in there and learn how you can get that unreal feeling of what it's like to improvise, interact with a band, make a melody your own, go up to any jam session without worrying about what's going to happen. This course is going to spell it all out for you. And down the road in the future, you could be taking those solos that you've always wanted to take and get that. Well, it is indescribable, the feeling of what it's like to be playing. And when you listen to this Mike Brecker solo just shortly, that's what I feel when I play live on stage. It is the best feeling of all time, and I want to share it with the world. And the best way I could think of sharing it with the world is to make this course so that you can enjoy that feeling as well instead of hearing me talk about it. So go and click the link in the description and get the course, because you're going to love it. It's my lifetime's work and you're going to love it. Okay, moving on to today's show. Oh, by the way, you get all the usual goodies in the description. If you're watching, you know, if you're watching this in the future, you'll get the free masterclass, etc., etc. So let's move on to the main part of the show today, which is basically me being a fanboy for Michael Brecker. But do you know what I love? I love watching people loving things. I don't care if they're loving music, horse riding, you know, baby wear, God knows what. When you see somebody digging something, oh, it's the best feeling in it. So I dig this Mike Brecker solo so much that I thought you might enjoy me seeing me rave about it. This is his tenor solo from Some Skunk Funk with the Brecker Brothers, which is taken from the Heavy Metal Bebop album. And it is full on. This is just in your face funk. So here we go. I'm going to go behind the screen. I'm going to rave about this solo, and hopefully you're going to learn a thing or two about what improvising looks like at the very highest level. I'll see you back there. Okay, welcome behind the screen. It's like the Wizard of Oz behind the screen. Right, here's the first very obvious thing about Michael Brecker's solo on Some Skunk Funk from the Heavy Metal Bebop album. He's using electronic effects on his sax, okay? So he's sacrilegiously drills a hole in the neck of his Mark VI, and they put this little contact mic thing in there, which goes into his effects. Now, he's using an effect called a T-wah or an envelope filter, depending how you want to call it. And I've got one here, but as soon as I put it in front of me, it's going to disappear because I'm using green screen technology for this video and the envelope filter is green. But just for fun, I'll hold it up and it's going to disappear. Look at that. You can't see me through it. But it's by, I've got this Dodd envelope filter. It's called FX25, but it's a bit chipped. That sounds wicked live, and you get that Mike Brecker wow wow wow. Like when the note hits, you can set the, you can get the settings dialed in, so when each note hits, it goes wow wow wow, and you can actually open the filter by playing louder and softer with your sax. So that's why the sax doesn't sound like a normal sax. It's got that wow wow wow. It sounds super funky, you know, really 70s vibe. Obviously, the next thing is this solo is a masterpiece of how you construct a logical solo, which is exactly what I talk about in Improvisation Mastery. And I've been teaching you guys this for the last God knows how long. He plays one phrase like a call, and then he'll answer it with another thing. And then he'll come back to the call, then he'll develop the call, then there'll be another answer, then he'll have a new idea. And his solo is divided into beautiful 8-bar chunks. And within each 8-bar, you normally have 2 4-bar sections. So let's start playing the solo. And I'll spell it all out for you. This is heavy. This is the head. Break. Right. Starts bluesy. Pentatonic. Old bluesy, right. And then it goes into... This next section is the chord changes. So he does 8 bars of just super funky sax. Now, if you were taking my advice, you would transcribe that and nick all those blues licks, because how many good blues licks are in there? This one. Also, how well does he throw the rhythm around? All those different accents. One more time. See how he's throwing the rhythm around? Right, now the next section is the chord changes section, where the band are doing all these weird slash chords. And then there's a weird 7-8 bar and then a band interlude. Let's check it out. So this is what you might call the second little chapter. Right, so that's mostly 16th notes. And he started doing the thing which he's going to build for the rest of his solo, which is this, you know, double harmonic fingering Coltrane thing. Let's hear that one more time. It's mostly 16th notes, so it's completely different from the previous 8 bars where he was bluesing out on the pentatonic. And look at that. Within the space of a few bars, he's gone from the lowest note in the instrument to one of the highest notes. He's using the whole range of the horn when he improvises. Altissimo. Killer. Killer. And he's using rhythmic displacement. Using different groupings. Check it out. All right, now he chills out for a few bars while the band have got the interlude. And then it's into the next section of his solo. So, band. One, two, three, four. There's the call. There's the answer. There's the call. But he's developed it. So there you go, classic example. First off. Call, answer. Call, developed. New idea. So, that is how you build a really awesome, funky solo on one groove. Play something, answer it. Play something and develop it, which leads into the next idea, which with these little short note groupings. Let's hear that one more time. Next idea. That was the idea. Then he plays it again. So check it out. Idea. Play again. Play again, different rhythm. Play again, different rhythm. So play it. Play it again. Play it again, different rhythm. Play it again twice with a different rhythm. Absolutely classic. Play it. Play it again. Different rhythm. Play it twice. Now he's developed it. He's taken that idea and gone ba ba da ba ba da ba up, like the Coltrane double fingering thing, into the next idea, which is the next chapter of his solo. So he's already stretched one idea over 4 bars. Now he's keeping it going. Answer. Play again. Answer. Play again. Develop it. Play again. Finish it. How about that for 8 bars of perfect solo construction? Answer. Play it. Answer it. Play again. Play again. Boom, boom. Next chapter. Right, so the next chapter is he plays really bluesy for four bars, then he gets an idea, and then he works at that idea like a dog gnawing a bone, and he's basically throwing the rhythms. So it's absolute. This is all you need to know about building a solo. Let's hear this bit again. Bluesy. New idea. Right, then he moves into the next chapter. And the next chapter is running 16th notes, okay? So he runs these 16th notes, which is building the rhythmic intensity. And then he starts doing these ripples. And the ripples at the end of this are what form this killer 8-bar build-up. But that's to come. So let's hear the 16th note section. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, Right. Now, he goes for this full 8-bar build-up with these rippling pentatonic patterns. Number one, it is technically off the scale ridiculous. And number two, it builds up the excitement to this bluesy altissimo climax, which is wet yourself good. Okay, let's hear the build-up. 3, 4, go! 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then back to the original. And then just when you thought it couldn't get any better, it goes back to the idea he had 2 lots of 8 bars ago to finish it off. 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Woo! Breakdown. Follow that, Randy Brecker. So, there you go. That is how you construct a solo. I tell you what, it's so good. I'm just going to listen to it all again. Ready? Here we go. Let's get the break as well. And now that you hear the whole thing again, you're gonna start to hear how all the chapters are put together in blocks. You know, he's got the 8-bar groove and then the slash chords where he plays 16th notes. He's got the band, doesn't play anything for a bit. And then 2 sets of 8 bars where he does call and response with himself, a bluesy section, and then into the 16th notes, and then the ripples, and then the ripples. He keeps rippling up and up and up and up through 8 bars. Hits the climax where he just rips into the blues lick, which incidentally, if you watched my episode about the blues sax, that's where I took the lick from, this exact moment. So you might recognize it. And then back to the idea he had 16 bars before to finish the solo off. Boom, send off Randy Brecker solo. Okay, let's check it out. Woo! Slash chords. Right, band interlude. Coming up for the call and response. Answer. He plays like a drummer. He literally plays like a drummer. Bluesy. sound better. 16th. Ripples. Ripple build up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Same idea as before. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ba da 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 da. Woohoo! How good is that? How good is that? That is just everything you need to know about soloing in this style. Obviously, it's like a complete balls-to-the-wall funk jam, this. It's not, you know, there's lots of different types of soloing for lots of different situations. But if you want to play heavy funk, that is one of the best ways I can think of doing it. And he combines everything that I teach in improvisation mastery. Heavy rhythm, heavy groove. In the middle of that playthrough, I said he literally plays like a drummer. Heavy, heavy rhythm. Fantastic ideas. Great sound. Fantastic blues licks, which he's learned. Fantastic patterns, which he's using to build up excitement. Technically, all over the instrument. That is such a heavy solo. If that if that doesn't light you up, I doubt you like jazz funk very much. All right, let's get back to the studio. So thanks very much for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed me raving about that killer Michael Brecker solo. And I hope you also enjoyed learning a thing or two about improvising. And the next time you listen to one of your favorite solos, you can sort of start analyzing it in a similar way that I just did to that solo. And you can start to build the pieces towards you improvising like that. You can play little segments like that. And you'll learn all about it in Improvisation Mastery. Did I mention that yet? And if you're thinking this video is a bit cobbled together today, you're 100% right. It is Saturday, and this is raw honesty for you. It's 6:30 on Saturday night. The video's out at 7 a.m. on Sunday. So yes, very much a rush job. But I cannot go a week without giving you content. It's my religion. It's my duty to serve. As usual, thank you to everybody who's bought me a coffee. Thank you to everybody who's jumped into Improvisation Mastery. Thank you just if you're watching and enjoying the content as well. I'll try and get something a bit more pre-programmed for next week's video. But in the meantime, practice hard, practice smart. And just like I've been doing for this entire show, enjoy your music. See you later. Hi, I'm Prozac.